Hello and welcome to session 14, Manage Semantic Models. I'm Andrew Conniff, a Microsoft technical trainer specializing in data and AI, and today we will explore managing semantic models in Power BI Service. Let's dive right in. In this session, we're going to discuss using Power BI Gateway to connect on-premises data sources and configure a scheduled refresh for a semantic model, configure incremental refresh settings, and manage and promote semantic models. Gateway software acts like a bridge. It allows organizations to retain databases and other data sources on the on-premises networks and access the on-premises data in cloud services such as Power BI and Azure, or analysis services. There are two types of premises gateways. Organizational mode allows multiple users to connect to multiple on-premise data sources and is suitable for complex scenarios. Personal mode allows one user to connect to the data source. This type of gateway can be used only with Power BI and it can't be shared with other users. So it's suitable in situations when you're the only one in an organization who creates reports. The scheduled refresh feature in Power BI Service allows us to define frequency and time slots for a refresh of a particular semantic model. Scheduling the refresh of our data will save us time as we don't have to manually refresh the data. It also ensures that the end user can access the most up-to-date data. In addition to the scheduled refreshes, we can refresh a semantic model at any time by performing an on-demand refresh. This type of refresh doesn't affect the next scheduled refresh time. The incremental refresh feature in Power BI is a popular feature because it allows us to refresh large semantic models quickly and as often as we need to without having to reload historical data each time. Traditionally, complex code was required for running incremental refreshes, but we can now define a refresh policy within Power BI Desktop. The refresh policy is applied when we publish to the Power BI service, which then does the work of managing partitions for the optimized data loads, resulting in the following benefits: quicker refreshes, more reliable refreshes, and reduced resource consumption. Business intelligence involves collaboration and sharing semantic models across organizations. Workspaces is a powerful way to collaborate within our organization. However, if our organization has many different semantic models that can be accessed by many users, we may want to take measures to manage those semantic models. For instance, we may want to direct our users to the most up-to-date and highest quality semantic model in our workspace. Or we may want to restrict the reuse of semantic models across a workspace. To ensure our organization has consistent data for making decisions and a healthy data culture, it's important to create and shape and share optimized semantic models and then endorse those semantic models as the one source of truth. Report creators can then reuse those endorsed semantic models to build accurate standardized reports. Microsoft Information Protection Sensitivity Labels provide a simple way for our users to classify critical content in Power BI without compromising productivity or the ability to collaborate. Sensitivity labels can be applied on semantic models, reports, dashboards, and data flows. When data is exported from Power BI to Excel, PowerPoint, or PDF files, Power BI automatically applies the sensitivity labels on those exported files and protects it according to the labels in the files and the encryption that are passed along. This way, our sensitive data remains protected no matter where it is. Performance and usage metrics are available as features for use in workspaces. We can see who's using our reports and what actions are being done on the reports and what performance issues exist. Usage metrics reports are available for Power BI Pro users and can only be accessed by users with the role type of admin, member, or contributor. To view, navigate to a workspace, find the report or a dashboard, use the ellipsis, open it up, and say View Usage Metrics Report. Let's go to Power BI Service and see how this looks. So here we are in our Power BI Service, and I'm logged in as the same account that I have in the Power BI Desktop, which we're going to see here momentarily. I have a default workspace, and if I go there, there isn't anything here. So we're going to choose to publish our application to our default workspace. Select it,
And we are now publishing our semantic model and report to the default workspace. It has succeeded. Let's check. All right. And if we look, we now have our report and our semantic model. Dashboards are created only in the service. So in order to create a dashboard, we will first open up our report and decide what we want to add to our dashboard. In this case, I'm just going to grab a couple of items sort of randomly here. And it says, where do I want to pin it? Well, I want to pin it to a dashboard. And we'll pin that visual. I can now create a mobile layout or go to the dashboard. We may as well look at the mobile layout, and we can see it's pinned our visual there. We can unpin it and it'll put it in the well here for design in case we want to add more items. I can also look at the web layout and we'll see I have my images here. We can continue along this path. From our report, I can go to the multiple different pages and I can pin different visuals to the dashboard. So in this case, an existing dashboard. When I go to my workspace, we can see that now the dashboard is here, and go to my dashboard. I can edit, I can add tiles manually, web content images. I can add text to my dashboard. So remember, the dashboard links us to the report page. So when I click on it, it takes me to the report page, and we could continue building from this report. I could open a different report from this workspace and add some visuals there. We'll add one more. And once we have them, we can move them around however we want. Now, as far as the design goes, we can select different themes. Here's a light theme. I have a dark theme I can look at. I have colorblind friendly, which is going to make sure my contrast is hard enough, varied enough that it'll be easy to read. And I can customize this as well. So I can change the colors, make them look a little bit how you would like to see them. And we can export this and save it, export it. We can download the JSON theme or upload JSON themes. So you can have your designers come in, set everything up how they want it, download that theme, and then reuse it over and over again by uploading it to all of your new items. We can also provide a background image if that's what we want to do. We'll save this here and we'll go back to our workspace. Over here, you'll notice we have two different views of our workspace. The view that we have here, the lineage view, shows our dashboard. At the top, we have our report. It's backed up by the semantic model. And then here are the data sources that we are connecting to. So if I refresh, the little warning pops up. Well, that little warning tells us that we are not connected to our data. We are unable to connect. And the reason is all of our data sources live on the virtual machine that I'm working on, and they're not in the cloud, and I haven't set up any connection to the data. So that's the next step to do. I'm going to download the data gateway. I'm going to download personal mode. All right, now that that's downloaded, we're going to go ahead and open that file. All right, we'll go ahead and accept the terms and conditions and install it in the default section. I'll authenticate. Okay, now that I've authenticated my gateway, it's online and ready to use, but it's not completely set up yet. So if I go now to my data sources, we'll see we are still unable to connect. And the fastest way to get to this setting is to just select go to settings, and it takes us right to the place we need to be. So here are my data source credentials. And what I need to do is edit my credentials. All right, so let's just connect to our web sources and let's test it out. So let's see in our lineage view if we can connect and refresh. And if we refresh our data, we'll still get a warning, but we are able to connect to our model for our CSV, and the connection was successful. You'd then go back and set up your SQL Server with your logins and everything, and all of that would work. Back in our main view, we can get information about our reports. We can export and analyze in Excel. We can get quick insights and we can view them. And if we'd like any of these insights, we find them helpful, we can add them to our report as such. Back in our workspace, we have lots of other controls that we can handle here, but this is the basics of setting up a workspace, connecting to our data and authenticating so that we can do refreshes, creating dashboards, and then from here, you would publish applications and share and be able to add all of the license information that you would need. And that brings us to the end of this demonstration.
This concludes our session. There are many ways to continue your learning journey. We encourage you to watch the other videos in this course or search out your next favorite topic on Microsoft Learn at aka.ms/learn.